Welcome by Retro Machines. My name is Victor Bart and in this video we're gonna try out a lot of motherboards which just came back from recapping. A friend of mine just recapped 5 motherboards for me. So in this video we're gonna put CPUs on it, coolers, some memory, and then we will test the boards out so that we have sets that are ready to be used in a system. So let's see what we're gonna use. We have a 300 watt AOPA power supply, Alpha coolers with AS tech fans, AMD XP coolers with 6 cm Xeon fans, which now are modified to use on a BP6, 2 simple coolers because I don't have another set high-end coolers. There we have an Athlon 700 slot A, a Pentium 3 1 GHz and a Celeron 300A. Here we have a compact keyboard, the test video card is a Matrox G450, some tools, some terminal paste and some CPU brackets for the slot 1 and slot A boards because they are missing. And here we have 256 megabyte PC133 modules. We have an MSI K7 Pro and I didn't give a CPU with it. So this is the only board where we are not sure if it will work. Here we have an Abit BE62 and it is a perfect for 40B overclocker motherboard. So it's really nice that it's up and running again. Here we have an Abit BP6 with dual Celeron 400 MHz. Another Abit BP6 with dual Celeron 366 MHz. And an Abit BP6 with dual Celeron 433 MHz. So we're gonna start with the Abit BP6 boards. The Abit BP6 is a really nice motherboard with an Intel 440BX chipset and it supports dual Celerons and overclocking. So it's the perfect motherboard for the Celeron CPUs. Let's start with the board with the Celeron 433 MHz and I will put the motherboard on this piece of foam. The 433 MHz Celerons are the least overclockable CPUs from which I have. So I'm gonna put the simple Cooler Master coolers on it. The little coolers are enough for basic overclocking if you have some airflow in your system. So now let's do the board with the 400 MHz Celerons. And I will put on the Alpha coolers and I see that I still need to clean them, but they can go on the CPUs for now. So now we're gonna do the board with 366 MHz Celerons and these are the best overclockers. They probably will go 550 megahertz or maybe even faster. So I'm gonna put AMD Athlon XP coolers on it with the Xeon fans. And with the grinder I removed here some parts of the coolers so they don't interfere with the caps. And with the installation of the caps, that friend made sure that they were sticking out enough to make a little bit more room for the coolers. So you need to be really careful when pushing down the clips with the screwdriver like this, because sometimes you need to use some more force and if you slip out you will damage the motherboard. I found a 256 megabytes PC133 CAS2 Apacer memory module. So this is the fastest SD RAM module that I have, so I will try it out because I want to know if this will work. Let's start with the Celeron 433 MHz set. Okay, 2 CPUs detected, memory is detected, check some error. But that is a normal error if a system didn't turn on for a while. Okay, it's not turning on. Let's get a PC speaker. Let's try different memory. Okay, the memory was broken. Celeron 400, 2 CPUs, 256 megabytes of memory. Nice. Okay, 2 CPUs detected, 366 megahertz and 256 megabytes of memory. Nice. I will show you how easy it is to overclock the Celeron 366 to 550. You put it on the CPU speed 550, 100 MHz bus. Save and exit. So there you have it, Celeron 550 MHz. Nice and easy. So now I have four working Abit BP6 sets. Yes, I love this motherboard. And it's really great to overclock on it and tweak around with it. It's just one of the nicer motherboards from this era. I'm now gonna try the MSI K7 Pro with the AMD 750 chipset. But first we need to install the CPU brackets here, because it's missing on this board. But luckily I have some spares. So let's try this one, which can fold down. Because this one, from the first generation, you can't fold it down. This one has push pins, so we need to pull them out, push in the board. So it's flush with the board, and then push the pins down. And you can fold them down like this, and up like this. I have an Athlon 700 MHz with 512 kilobyte cache. And a simple Cooler Master cooler. Okay, the fan is a little bit worn out. Come on, you can do it. Come on, board. Go for it. Uh-oh. No beeping. The fan is spinning, but we don't get a display. Let's see. Let's change the memory. Yes! Okay, I don't know what's happening, but it was giving a display. Let's try a different video card. Let's try a PCI video card and see if that will help. Nope, nothing. Let's try another video card. Okay, the Viper 550. Okay, this looks better. So maybe this motherboard has problems with certain video cards. Okay, we can overclock with this motherboard. And also the voltage of the CPU can be changed. So that is really nice. This is really awesome. We now have an nice repaired motherboard with an Athlon 700 MHz. So let's check the last board, the Abit BE62. And this is the best overclocking motherboard with the Intel 440BX chipset. Also here the CPU brackets are missing. And I will install this brackets that also can fold down. This whole row of caps were broken and bulging out and one big mesh. But the board was still working with all the broken caps. But this is so much better. We're gonna really overclock with this board. First, I'm gonna try out this Celeron 300A. And this is really the overclocking Celeron King. Yes! Celeron 300A detected with 512 megabytes of memory. Let's go into the BIOS. You can really overclock this board per megahertz. So you can really tweak your settings up to 200 megahertz front side bus. That is double the speed of the Intel 440BX chip. This CPU is 66 megahertz front side bus. And the multiplier is 4.5. So the easiest way to overclock a Celeron 300A is just go first to 100 MHz, because most chips will run on this speed. And we overclocked our Celeron from 300 MHz to 450 MHz. Nice and easy. But this simple cooler is not enough to run it 24 hours a day. Okay, this set is up and running again, but I want to test out one more CPU, because here I have a Pentium 3 1 GHz. So this is, I think, the fastest Pentium 3 on slot 1. Yeah, maybe they have a 1.13, but I'm not sure. But I bought this some time ago, so let's try this one out on this board. Okay, this is correct, because it's now in safe modus, because it detected a new CPU, so we need to go in the BIOS. It detected that some Pentium 3, so that is good. I think the BIOS is already updated. And now we go to 133 MHz, because that's the front side bus of this Pentium 3. So now we are not overclocking, but just setting it to the correct speed. Now we need to set the PCI CPU front side bus clock to 1/4, so we don't overclock the PCI bus. Okay, we can set it to 101 HCP speed, but that's way too fast. But let's set it to 2/3 speed, so we will overclock the HCP slot now, but most cards will take that. Okay, Pentium 3 1 GHz. Nice. So now this board is repaired and up and running again. I will probably make some overclocking videos with it, and then focusing on the Celeron 300A, because I will probably push it over 500 MHz on this board. But I need to work on the cooling, so if a company wants to sponsor me some water cooling supplies, I will take it and make a sponsored video of the overclocking adventures, because I think we need some really awesome cooling for this CPU instead of this simple cooling block. Thank you, Dave, for repairing these 5 great motherboards. They are up and running again, and he soldered over 120 caps to repair these 5 motherboards. So that's really awesome. And to thank him for repairing the motherboards, I gave him the 286 dumpster machine. So no videos about that machine anymore, but he already restored it in a new case, because the case cover was missing, and he upgraded memory to 4 megabyte, but with SIP modules, so that's really awesome. So that machine gets a new life in a new case, and it will be really awesome. Thanks for watching. Please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment. You can check out Retro Machines on Facebook and support me on Patreon.